To some extent, Truth Social is here. The Donald Trump backed social media network, which is supposed to be a free speech with a big asterisk haven for right wingers who were not satisfied with Gab and Getter and Parler and all of those other places that have already done this exact same thing. You can now try to sign up for Truth Social. It probably won't work, but you can try. Last night, late, there was an update posted to their website saying an issue was under investigation. That will be the first of many issues that will eventually be up for investigation, because your identity will likely be stolen. Your information will be sold to like chain email groups and things like that. Just wait. So they had a big outage for like 8 hours. And then apparently, because of the great success, and maybe this is true, maybe so many people were trying to sign on to it, that there's a wait list. They're saying there's all this demand. So some journalists, including an insider, tried to sign up, and this is what they saw. There was a wait list to sign up for it. And so other people tried to download it and it kept failing. Bear in mind, after jumping through all of these hoops, what do you get? You get, as you'll see in this comparison, the most obvious copy of Twitter ever, but one where you can once again listen to the truths from Donald Trump.
Ooh, red check mark. Got him.
It's better.
Truth. You're number 157,000 in line for the truth. Until then, keep spouting lies. Like, it's not fair. As a comic, this is not fair. You cannot just be a full satirical, self-containing idiot the way that Trump is and all of Trumpism is. Launching a website, a social media site called Truth. This is every SNL sketch. It is not fair for those of us.
It's unjokable.
It's unjokable. You did it. George Orwell's like, well,
come on. I mean, what am I supposed to do with this? Like it's truth. I'm sending my truth, which, by the way, that sounds like the most lefty thing the right has ever said, is that I want to post my truth. But they're doing it. Aww. They're doing it, and it'll be up for a little bit, and it'll probably inevitably fail. But yeah, like, it's gonna be so scandal-ridden with privacy holes and the information being sold. Just wait, and it's not gonna have free speech. First of all, you already can't mock the company. You think you're gonna be able to mock Donald Trump on there? I mean, look at these other right-wing. Getter has the exiled Chinese billionaire backer. You will be banned on Getter if you refer to him as a spy, which I have no idea if he's a spy or not. But that ain't a haven of free speech if you can't question the people financially backing the platform. what would they think if Twitter did that? If you criticized whoever it is in charge of Twitter these days, you'd be banned. They'd be cool with that. That's totally fine. That's free speech, baby. Ridiculous. Anyway. Oh, by the way, in addition to copying like the whole Twitter thing, look at this. Someone noted that even their logo clearly is taken from a British fleet telematics and fuel efficiency company that has used it since at least 2019.
So good.
They're gonna be sued. By the way, that company, Trailer, is now seeking legal advice to understand next steps and options available to protect our brand. So they're likely to be sued by this French or British trailer company. I thought they were for the truckers and the trailers, but apparently not. For more political news breakdowns, interviews, stories of activism, and me trying my hardest to care about the occasional big celebrity news story, subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/thedamagereport. And you can ring the bell wherever it is so you don't miss anything.